her than I ever looked before. First is the sunshine, and the second is rain. Third is the roses that bloom in the lane. There's no need explaining, the one remaining is somebody I adore. I'm looking over a four-leaf clover that I've overlooked before.
Savior of the world, we indeed are gathered to worship and to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our sister Arlene, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our own grief. Paul says in Romans, when we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead, by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we've been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we do remember before you today our sister Arlene. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen. So we've got a couple scriptures to kind of set the foundation for our celebration of Arlene's life and the celebration of the gospel for her. From Proverbs 3, trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make straight your paths. And from 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now, we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I've been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide these three, but the greatest of these is love. Oh, the thought of Arlene being face to face with her Lord. I want to introduce Paige, one of Arlene's wonderful grandkids, and she's going to share a special song for us. Something in the Water, come on up, Paige. And I think this is a great song because, as Paul said, we've been united through the faith of our baptism to Christ's death, and we certainly shall be united with him in a resurrection like this. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And I know your grandma loved it as she joins with us in a way we can. scarcely even understand. So now we have some pictorial tributes as we continue to celebrate Arlene's life.
Ooh. we will have an opportunity. If you want to stand, you can come to the mic, but if you want to even just stand from where you are and share any celebrations that you would like, stories, even just some words, descriptive words are great too. So you'll have a chance to do that. I want to give you that heads up. I know that when I think of Arlene, I think of her faith. I mean, she just loved the Lord. So we continue with our thank you. I want to invite those who want to share some words to do so now.
And thanks for everyone coming. One thing is really amazing, my mom, and scary or all of us, is birthday parties, Christmas, Easter, and even Thanksgiving. She as a kid didn't have birthday parties. And so it was adamant, we have birthday parties. So you notice a lot of birthday cakes and stuff and celebrations?
Yeah.
Okay. That was mom. You can see her journey is amazing. From all the way from Paulsville, where she graduated class of 48, all the way through for all the kids that we've got. Now I have grandkids, nieces, nephews, and she loved them all. The thing that's amazing about her, she never judged anybody. She made a comment. In my life, I had some tough situations went through. And I got through it because of mom and dad. But one day, things changed for the positive for me a lot. And I got to meet a real special person in my life. But it was interesting. My mom made a comment. After all said and done, don't screw it up. I died at mom, your Paige thing. Amazing. Aaron, him, amazing kid, and a great family. And so we're gonna miss her big time. But I really appreciate all of you coming. It was great. Thanks.
Grateful that my mother-in-law always treated me like one of the family. She took me in, you know, and it's been great. And I love her, and I'm going to miss her.
I hadn't really planned to say anything. I grew up with Alan and the family. The first time I met her, because you have such a birthday theme here going, was the first time I met her, she held a birthday party for Alan in their old house, which was really small, really packed full of people, and she pulled it off miraculously, and it was a great birthday party and a great introduction to the family of the Phillipses, and she was wonderful. And I knew her all the way through high school and graduated with Alan. And she was a stable force through my growing up. So I thank you for sharing your mom with us.
I don't know if you remember me, but I'm Gary, the younger brother. And I had an opportunity to see my mom a long time, and it's very hard to say how much I miss her because I've been here for a long time because you're sick and I've been sick. But Alan says it best. I mean, we're family. Mom's going to have a birthday. Dad's going to have a birthday on the 16th of December. Mom's is 24th. Maybe we can have a big birthday.
several times. But if you remember the picture up here that shows her looking through a card, that is how I remember Arlene. Because she was funny. In our times of Skyping, she would have Brenda and I just laughing. She would go in and out of telling her stories. And I, like with Gary, I look forward to meeting you, Gary, and getting to know you, and knowing the family more. And I wish that I could have gotten to know Arlene, just like all of you have, especially the gentleman back here. But I will look forward to the opportunity to get to know her through your lives and through your lives. So I'm just excited to be here.
I just want to thank all of you that came. The way the situation is now, I just thought it was going to be like 8 or 9 of us, just family. So I really appreciate all of you others that came. And we're just happy moms. She was tough. She'd been through a lot of really hard things, physically especially, and she had a lot of pain, but they took really good care of her at Martha and Mary. They just went over the top taking care of her. She has so many people doing different things watching over her. And it was fun going to visit there. I got to know a lot of the people that worked there. And she was very happy there. She enjoyed being there. She had fun with a lot of people. Most all of us got to visit her at times, and we would do birthday parties at the nursing home. At first, she was able to come home, but eventually she couldn't get up out of her wheelchair at all. And so then we just would take the party to where she was, and we had several of those, including my daughter and grandson and son-in-law who came all the way from Utah. We would set up parties and have them there.
really special that you can give someone to just feel truly, truly and completely loved and appreciated for who you are. And I felt that for my grandma. I also think that I go camping an obscene amount of times because that's my memory with my grandma and my grandpa, is going fishing for way too many hours. And my grandma, just like, I give Nick a hard time when we go camping because I'm like, you're not doing it right, because my grandma was the pro. She had it down and had the meals put together and her whole setup of how the camp would run, and I just have great memories of that time together as a family. And I'm just happy to be here and with everyone, so thank you. It means a lot to me to be here, so thank you.
Those are beautiful tributes and beautiful words. I too am just so thankful that my journey got to intersect with Arlene's, and I got to be one of her pastors for many years. And usually it would be in Martha Mary around the Lord's Supper and bringing her communion. But even before she went to Martha Mary, lots of times with her, the laughter, but just like that passage from Proverbs said, trust in the Lord. That she clung to God's promise in Christ Jesus. That was at the core of who she was, and she clung on to God's promises. And since she loved parties so much, which is something really kind of cool that I've got to hear today, I can say this, that when Paul envisions us seeing the Lord face to face, like in that passage from 1 Corinthians 13. You know, right now we only know in part, but then we'll be totally known, we'll know everything. So I don't know about you, but I'm kind of inquisitive, and there's lots of questions I have in this life about lots of things, and lots of things about how God is involved in the world. I trust in the word and sacraments. I trust in what the scriptures tell us about how God has redeemed this world in Christ Jesus our Lord. But there's a lot of things we wrestle with. But just zero in on that promise from 1 Corinthians 13, just for a second. Paul says that we only right now know in part, but then we shall know fully. We see through a mirror dimly, but then we shall see face to face. You know, that's a part of our journey, is having some uncertainty and not knowing everything. But here's the good news, is that God knows us fully and has known Arlene fully the whole time. And now she sees the Lord face to face. What a party. In Revelation, we hear about a new heaven and a new Jerusalem, and no more sorrow, no more tears, no more crying. That is what Arlene shares in them. Thanks be to God, all of this because of what God has done for us in Christ Jesus. Amen, amen. So I'd like to now ask you to join with me in a time of prayer. Gracious and loving God, in holy baptism you knit together your chosen people, together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven that Arlene now shares in, and on earth, your light and your peace. God, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin daily and rise to share in the new life in Christ Jesus. God, give courage and faith to those who mourn. Be with Chet. Hold him in your care. We give thanks for their 71 years of marriage. God, we pray that you'll be with Brenda and her family. and Alan and Larry and Gary, with the whole, all of Arlene's family, with her five grandkids and her two great-grandsons. Hold them all in your care, that in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection, they can cast all of their sorrow on you and know they have strength to meet all the days ahead. God, grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and in pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to hear, to and know, and bear witness to your light and life. Help us, God, in the midst of so many things that we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. Finally, God of all grace, we give thanks that because of his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection, he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall also live, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we pray, I invite you to pray with me the prayer that our Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. So we place Arlene into God's loving care. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Arlene Phillips. Acknowledge, indeed, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of all the saints in life. Amen. As I send you out with this benediction, and we have a closing song celebrating the goodness of God that makes all the difference for us this day, I want you to know that grief is disorientating. We've orientated our lives around the people we love, and when they're gone, we're disorientated. So give yourself lots of grace. It is disorientating, but you're not going crazy. You just miss Arlene. But God's love, God promises to pour his love into that space. So give yourself lots of grace and know the Lord goes indeed with you. So be sent forth with this benediction this day. The God of peace who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you complete in everything good, so that you may do God's will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in God's sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. We go forth in the peace.